once again. Without any further ado, I think we should immediately go and meet our fabulous guest this evening. The man, the self-styled wizened prince of pop, none other than Mr. Alan Freeman, ladies and gentlemen. Next to him, the goddess of song, who was voted a huge hit on last week's show, Neneh, ladies and gentlemen. Next along, top footballer, great man, enormous man, John Fashanu, ladies and gentlemen. And finally, sitting in the end place, Britain's top light entertainer, Mr. Vic Reeves, ladies and gentlemen. The jukebox has been repaired. The train is on the rails, ready for to try and get to the Bridge of Love there. We're going to take it to the bridge and maybe even across past the celebrities this evening. There's some sweets in it for them to have when it goes past. What a top show, ladies and gentlemen. Let's move straight along with the first record, which is by MC Hammer.
If I keep looking, that love I'll find. The picture grows clearer and clearer.
Well, there we are, MC Hammer. Have you seen her? It was a hit for the Shy Lights quite a long time ago, but nobody knows. Still, we'll come to that in a moment. Alan,
I thought you'd say that to me first. Actually, I was a very old man when this originally came out, Jules. And I think the Shy Lights performance was extremely good, but I really think that this has been quite magnificently updated.
A lot of sauciness in the video, did you think?
No, I thought the birds were pretty ordinary, and I thought that pair of blue underpants was ridiculous. And furthermore, he's got a very big bum. Nevertheless, I think that this is quite a beautiful updating of the song, and I love it, and I think it's going to be a smasheroonie.
You liked it, that's what I liked to hear. Neneh?
I preferred his last tune. I prefer him as a dancer rather than a rapper, but then, you know, I'm the sort of person that's into crustier kind of hip-hop and music. And I'm not promoting myself, but the one thing that I find that sort of gets on my nerves is like the overflow of cleavage in the girls, and you know, we've just, hold on. I've just sort of lost the plot there. What I was gonna say is, we just did a video. We had this guy sort of in this sort of slightly provocative outfit, and people at various TV stations and so on don't want to show it because of the way he looks. And you look at something like that, and it's like, how much cleavage can you get in? Mm. And it's like, nobody will say, it doesn't matter, because it's a woman. So I have to find that slightly gets on my nerves. Mm. But, you know, it'll probably be a massive hit. No doubt, I don't think it can fail at this point.
Yeah. John?
I like it. I agree what Nina said. I like his single before that. I think it was very nice. But I like this, and it's nice to see. I like the video, and nice to see nice, good-looking people in the video, and I think it'll be a hit.
Do you remember the Shy Lights version of it?
Yeah, I do, and I like that as well. But at the moment, MC Hammer, everything he touches is fantastic, as far as I'm concerned, right. You know.
It's quite a lot in that video.
Yeah, right.
Well, Vic Reeves.
Yes, Member Holland. I did enjoy that, and I enjoyed the Chilates. Originally, but the
Chilites.
The Chilites, yes. Their first version of that. And he had nice chevrons cut into his hair, didn't he? But there was a little bit where the rest of his group, they didn't put enough chairs in the video for him to all sit down so they had to bob about a bit. Well, he did a good job, and he wore some nice wide fronts. I would have preferred nice thermals. But
yes. I think I'd go with that. Certainly.
He did a good job.
I won, no.
So then, I think I'm very impressed with all of your delightful, lovely answers. If I know,
so you should be.
Yes, well, and it's a lovely. How many stripes on your suit?
More than you.
Yeah, that's
and
right.
You could have put a shirt and tie on, couldn't you?
Just button your lip and and I think vote if you may. Is that going to be a hit or a miss for MC?
No doubt, it will be a hit.
Oh, it's unanimous, ladies and gentlemen. And that's marvellous. That means that the love train,
good.
Hello, yeah. The love train will trundle along those
and
tracks getting towards the Bridge of Love. And I can also reveal that one of this week's mystery guests, ladies and gentlemen, is none other than
Well done.
Bob Mortimer. And it's a complete mystery because he's nothing to do with the record whatsoever.
Oh, no, this
what
is
are you doing here?
Lie.
Hello, Member Holland.
What are you doing? You were supposed to be at home boiling the onions up for me, too.
Mammy Reeves, I don't recognise you in those ties.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think the next record is... Record? I like the
record.
Record. The next record is going to be The Pretenders.
Give me a sense of purpose, a real sense of purpose now.
There we are, The Pretenders then, a sense of purpose. That's Gary Stretch there, boxing. I'm informed that there's a relationship between he, but that's neither here nor there. I'm not here to be an idle gossip. John, what did you, do you think that'll be a hit?
I like it. I'm not sure it'll be a hit or not, but I like Gary Stretch boxing. But I think that the video detracts from the music, and I couldn't quite remember what was going on. I was just watching the video, and I couldn't actually remember the music. Yes, because I'm a sports fanatic, yeah. That's right, yeah. So I like the boxing and I like Chrissy Hynde, but I didn't really like the music.
Fair enough. Neneh.
I really like Chrissy's voice, so I've got a real soft spot right there. I think she's got, like, the sexiest female voice in the rock, whatever you want to call it,
idiot.
Side of things. Yeah. So I kind of like that, and I hope it does well. And she's still around, which is nice. And
yes. As is Alan Freeman. I didn't mean that like that. Alan, I didn't mean that like that.
I think this is a record that doesn't need a video to it, because first of all, Chrissy Hynde is a total star. I mean, she has that enormous persona in anything she does. And sometimes, you know, singers need videos, and they need to be surrounded by tremendous sounds in order to get through. You could have this lady singing with an acoustic guitar and she would still be an absolute world star, and I think as it is that the whole record is absolutely tremendous, and I think without any doubt it's a very, very big hit.
Very conclusive. There was some evidence there. Mr. Reeves, Mr. Mortimer?
Well, I for one always like to see a bit of punching on the box. Vic?
Punching on the box.
Punching on the box. Oh, it's the sort of music I'd listen to if I was laying a stair carpet.
You don't know what you're talking about, though, do you? Really?
No,
you
make me look like no Reeves, it's the sort of music I would listen to if I was laying a stair carpet.
And well, I'd do a bit of technical drawing to it.
Well, fair enough. What I'm just saying, I'd lay a carpet to it, that's all. And if I bought a cheap nylon stuff and it wasn't going that well, that would cheer me right up.
Well, it's the thing is, the car doesn't
speaking of that, you didn't think there was she was voted Humanitarian of the Year recently,
she?
Yeah.
What does that mean, then?
I don't know, that's what I was asking you, I wondered.
You say you don't know what you're talking about,
no,
do you?
No, that's what I've got you
you're
on to explain.
You're leading on the basis of paperwork. Have you got a mind for yourself?
No, that's why I brought you on to help me.
I think we'll have to. We've only got one disc, haven't we?
Exactly. So, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, please cast your votes on The Pretenders and Sense of Purpose. Oh, we've got two hits and a miss. Two hits and a miss, and that means that we throw it to Mob Rule, ladies and gentlemen. We go up. Yes, let's have a little bit more of their speakers, shall we? So, ladies and gentlemen, if you think it's a hit, please shout hit. If you think it's a miss, please scream miss. It's a unanimous hit, ladies and gentlemen. Which is marvellous news, because I can now forward the train, and it's got a lovely little camera attached to the train, and as it gets nearer and nearer, the gents there, and it's going on to the bridge. We've got a derailment. What's so funny about a derailment? That's better. Thank you. So I'm going to move the train right along there.
Gorgeous.
Oh, move little train. Oh, through your
come on up.
In there, there should be some.
Yeah. We're getting there.
Sweets and delicacies for you. Happiness rings out once again. And now the next record is from Curtis Mayfield and Ice-T.
Not going to move that one.
Let's just say I've been born again. Here we are then, Curtis Mayfield and Superfly. He has recently suffered an awful accident and is in hospital as we speak, hopefully recovering, but he may never walk again. So I think that we've all got to be pleasant about him. Alan.
We hear a lot of soul singers, or a lot of singers who sing soul. without necessarily being soul singers. But Curtis Mayfield is the absolute epitome, this very light falsetto voice of a soul quality that comes from the very depth of the soul. And I think the man is a tremendous performer. I'd like to see it a hit. I've got my doubts.
Neneh.
Well, you know the brother can sing. You know, that just makes me so happy to see it, to see that. But then, you know, it's kind of spooky too because of what's happened. I mean, it's nice to see that he's come through because it's been kind of quiet on the Curtis front for some time. I grew up with his voice. You know, I love him. I hope he gets better.
Yeah, I think we all
and
do.
I hope that the record's a hit.
John?
I like you very much. Like Alan said, true soul singer, and I think I'll probably get it next week. I like it.
Yeah, I'd go out and buy that, yeah.
This week?
Concise, yeah, to the point. Mr. Reeves, you seem to have broken the train. Did you manage to focus on the record?
I've been fixing it for
you. Oh, thank you, sorry.
Cheeky get.
Thank you.
You're lying get.
Can we have a bit less of the lying? Thank you.
Sorry.
That record, do you think it'll be a hit?
Well, would you like me to talk about it first, or just want me to judge?
Well, talk about it.
All right, then. Well, I do like Curtis Mayfield and all his endeavours, and I'm so sorry about him unpleasantly being injured.
Yes, me too. I'm really rather upset about that. You've finished laying your stair carpet, and you haven't allowed for the drop. You're going to be down, right? That's the sort of thing that would pick you up.
It is, isn't it?
And,
You're right. How eloquently put. Shall we vote on that then, ladies and gentlemen of the jury? Let's see how we're going to go with that. A unanimous. Well, it went halfway.
Oh, it's changed. It's changed.
Well, no, still, you see, two hits and a miss. Yeah, yes, you see. And as much as Alan loves Curtis, he's being frank and he says he doesn't think it's going to be a hit. So he's throwing it to the ugly mob, ladies and gentlemen. Their faces again once distorted with hatred and venom. Get a fair trial, if you will, off of these people. Please shout boo or cheer for Curtis Mayfield. It's a religious experience. Well, from Curtis Mayfield, we go on to...
Are you going to make the train move, then, or what?
Well, I thought there was some... A train move, yeah, OK, all right.
On your way, little train.
It's a long old train, the love train. Anyway, I think we want to go on with Glen Medeiros now. What did you make of that?
Well, what a right lot of a couplers that was, wasn't it? But the thing is... No, but listen, it's quite raunchy and raucous. And say, for instance, you'd locked yourself in your fridge by accident and put that on in order to alert people to my situation.
They wouldn't come.
Well, they would come. They'd alert them, wouldn't
they? Oh, they would come, yeah.
You'd put that on your fridge, people and unlock it and let you out.
I'll tell you what, he's the first person we've seen on the night that I'd have a decent chance with in a fight.
You're not a violent man, no, surely.
I'm not, but I was just thinking.
But you are a violent man, aren't you?
When I hear music like that.
Ooh, John.
Didn't like it at all. No. Not my sort of music.
Well, there was nothing in it for you?
Nothing at all, no. I didn't like it. When it first started, I thought, well, this is nice, but no, didn't like it.
Do you think it might be a hit, though?
I doubt it.
No, no. Neneh?
What makes me laugh, right, is like 3 songs ago, he just stepped off the surfboard. And now, since doing a video with Bobby Brown, he's like, got all the dance steps, borrowed Bobby's shoes. He's like right in there with the groove. Sorry, Glenn.
Can't hang. Alan?
Is this not the Spanish geezer that had a ballad called Nothing's Gonna Change My Love For You or something? Is that right? A couple of years ago. Now, I think he's a very good ballad singer, but I think this record is really quite a mess. It doesn't ring true to me in listening to it, and it looks very, very posy to me, and I think it's very, very ordinary. I think the record's a mess. Sorry about that.
Well, in that case, ladies and gentlemen of the jury and gentlemen motorcyclists, could you please vote? Hold on a moment. understand the concept of what we're doing?
Not really, no.
Okay, it makes no difference. It's a... ladies and gentlemen. And that's particularly embarrassing and unfortunate for me because specially invited, he's probably coming to celebrate for Christmas this year. Glenn is here with us, and he is our mystery guest, and I just don't know what to say. I'm going to make it up to him, though. I can't apologise enough. Hello, there. Thank you so much for coming on, and as a special gift, I'd like to give you this original Poussin picture. It's stolen from a gallery, and I'd like you to have it. Well, thank you, Neneh. You sure you don't want it? We got it specially as a gift. Well, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry everybody didn't like your record. There you go. Thank you, and you sure you don't want the Swiss hand? There we are. Then. Thank you. Goodbye. Well, all of you are just totally embarrassed
at
this.
Why did you put us through this?
Well, they're moving along swiftly there. Let's go along with Eat and Psycho Couch. Very well then. Eat and Psycho Couch. John.
Not really for me. Not my sort of music, unfortunately.
Right.
Didn't really like it.
Okay.
Video didn't really do anything, you know. No.
Not your cup of tea though.
No.
Neneh?
Oh. I find that a lot of indie videos sort of a bit more interesting than your sort of run normal average. What you normally get, but I don't know what to say about that one. I don't think it'll be a hit, but it was kind of a bit more interesting to look at than some of the other videos we've seen.
Right.
You know.
Good point. Good straightforward point.
It's a bit useless.
I have the feeling that given sufficient airplay right throughout the country, the video and the sound of the record could well give it a top three status. I mean, I think it's what it's all about today. I still don't understand exactly what I saw and what I heard. What I feel is that with sufficient airplay, this could be a hit. That's all I can say.
Do you think that's true of any record? If it gets played a lot, it will be a hit?
No, not necessarily, because you can play a record that is very uninteresting a lot and turn the public off it forever. And in fact, you know, by playing what is a pretty ordinary record by an artist, you can actually ruin their follow-up chances. Because people sometimes think, oh, there's a new record by X, okay? Well, the last one was a lot of rubbish, and I don't even want to know about this one. So you've got to be very careful about that, but underlying factions tell me that could be a hit record. I don't particularly like it.
Right.
Can I say one thing?
Yes?
It did good in the indie charts, I think.
I think the record of the week in NME last week.
Yeah,
I think
so. Good name for a song too, Psycho Couch.
Yes.
Is that it? Wicked.
Yeah. Not a bad name for a band either, Eat.
Psycho Couch.
Vic Reeves.
Good. Oh, yeah. I like things moving about quickly around the house. I like the idea of that. Because you don't often see that, do you?
You're quite slow around the house, aren't you?
But you never see chairs. And I like this, where the chair moved from almost small
to...
Rather large.
Yes. Mm. Bob Mortimer.
Well, I thought it was the best video that we've seen all evening.
It had colour, charm.
Colours. They got the tiles a bit skew-whiff, I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah, I know. But that's probably a bad workman that was in there early on.
Exactly. They probably tried to do it themselves when they couldn't have an expert.
And serve
all
the wrong guests.
Well, thank you very much. Let's vote on whether then Eat and Psycho Couch is a hit.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Yeah. Oh, well, I'm afraid it is a... for Psycho Couch. It means we have to bring the... train back just a little bit. Oh, it's so exciting, that. They might be giants, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, I haven't caught anybody's finger or anything. They might be giants, ladies and gentlemen. Here they are, then.
Don't let's start. This is the worst part. To believe for all the world that you are my precious little girl. But don't let's start. I've got a weird heart and I don't get around how you get around. When you are alone, you are the cat, you are the phone, you are an animal. The words I'm singing now mean nothing more than me out to an animal. Wake up, smell the cat food in your bank account. Destruction over an arbiter. And do I need a boss to redeem me? This dungeon, don't let's start. This is the worst part. To believe for all the world that you're my precious little girl. But don't let's start. I've got a weak heart and I don't get around. How you get around?
They might be giants then. And don't let's start. A group from New York, Vic.
Well, they're this pair of gawks, aren't they? I call them gawks.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there's all people who stay in bedrooms a bit too long and they should remain there, as far as I'm concerned. How about you, Bob?
I don't know, really, Vic. It's a very catchy tune, you know? And you might think at first look that I could probably fight the singer, but I reckon he's got a real temper on him. And that if he lost his rag, you'd have had it. But it's catchy, but something about it I hate.
John.
I didn't like the video. It looked, you know, like it was just patched together, put together very quickly. I don't like that. I'm having to go against you, sorry. I don't like that.
No, fair enough. Neneh?
I thought the video was kind of... had a bit of quirk. It's quite good. I've got a sort of... I can't really deal with that American college music sound. I find it kind of... I get slightly allergic. I don't know why. But, I thought the video was quite good, but I don't like the song that much. Is that what I felt?
Well, I reckon that was the best video we've seen tonight.
Ooh. Oh, well done, by the way.
I thought the video was very well cut. I noticed that the lead singer was a bit out of sync with his mime towards the end. But, of course, we're only halfway through the record anyway. And it took me almost back to a kind of punk era, OK? I didn't find it American high school stuff at all. I found it almost nice punkish, and I found it very tuneful, and I think it's got possibilities. I like it.
Fair enough. Well, I think it's just left to vote then, please, ladies and gentlemen of the jury.
I don't know what to say.
I think so.
Just whatever you think. Oh, well, in fact, it's over to the audience. I mean, let's be realistic. It's not a hit, is it? But don't let me influence you. Right, come on then, you horrible mob, then. Let's look at you, and if you think it's a hit, shout, but don't do anything if you think it's a miss, all right? If you think it's a hit, go on. Right, and now, if you think it's a miss, which it clearly is, vote. There you are, it's a miss.
It's a miss.
So then, on to the next record, ladies and gentlemen. Babylon AD. Right, there's Babylon AD then. song from the new RoboCop film, and it's interesting enough, Chris Quintin of Coronation Street appears in the film, but doesn't